What's happening in entertainment? From Tinseltown to the Big Apple, this is your weekly entertainment magazine with Greg Dunmore of Pulsebeattv.
Pulse of a new generation. Pulsebeattv.
I can see hearts carved out of tree, letters intertwined, all time, yours and mine, that was mine.
Dunkershane, that was Wayne Newton, you know, in the song.
That's a very young Wayne Newton.
A very young Wayne Newton. But Dunkershane in German is thank you very much. And I want to say, first of all, Mildred Gaddis, thank you very much, because I have been just addicted to your show the last few days, because you have now the most riveting, powerful radio, giving me background on our presidential candidates like none other. So I want to say Dunkershane, because it has been really powerful.
Thank you. Glad you enjoyed it.
And we say Dunkershane because National German American Day. Now, you may be saying, because this is Black Talk Radio, and there's a connection that we've got to talk about. The reason why it is National German American Day, it used to be called German Day, it is because of the founding of Germantown in Philadelphia, one of the 13 colonies. And guess what?
What?
It was founded by German Quakers, and they were the first group of Americans that publicly denounced slavery in this country.
Penned in 1688, it's the first anti-slavery protest published in the United States. And it was signed not far from here, just a couple blocks down, at the home of one of Pastorius's Quaker friends. It's a profoundly Lutheran document, interestingly. Focuses on the Golden Rule and asks the question, would any person want to be treated the way slaves are treated? That is, would anyone want to be purchased, bought, sold, and enslaved for the course of one's life? Directly invokes the teaching of Jesus and of the Gospels and of the prophets before him, articulating the Golden Rule that we should not do unto another, no matter what their color, their background, their creed, what we would not want done to ourselves.
They had a decree that said slavery is a sin, slavery is obscene, and it must not exist in this country, and they formed a Society of Friends. So therefore, when we talk about German Day, which became German American Day, which is a national holiday, it is in salute to what these Germans did, German Americans, as we would call them today, and their public denouncement of this sinful thing called slavery, especially in the United States. So I just want to make that point.
You know, which one was it? And I know you'll know this. Gosh, Black German. Was it Mozart?
Yeah, could have been,
Bach,
yeah.
Beethoven. Been. One of them. One of them was a Black German.
So we got to talk about that. Now, I want to just say, in talking about some little German things, and we know the singer Marlene Dietrich, she was very well known, and Harrison Ford has a German background, and guess what? Guess whose real name is D-R-U-M-P-F? It's Durumf. Donald Durumf. That's his real name, you know, but he changed it over the years, or his family did, to Trump. Leonardo DiCaprio of German background, Sandra Bullock. Guess what? Ham as we eat today, smoke ham, Germany. Potato salad, Germany. Those chicken and dumplings that Aretha likes from Cracker Barrel, because of the German influence. But guess what's not German? German chocolate cake is not German. A guy by the name of Sam German, his last name, he's an American name, German. He's the one that is named after, but Black Forest cake, that is German. So I just want to make that point. But guess what? We're going to do something historical. I remember when you said, when we did the thing about Elvis Presley, that you've never had that discussion on the radio. So we're going to have a discussion about something that ties in with German that I think that you may have never had as a point of discussion, and it ties in with arts, entertainment, and culture. Now tell me, can you guess who this American singer of international acclaim, who would be among the first major American singers to sing in German language?
Füreinander, Johnny, so viel von dir. Ach, komm doch mal zu mir. Noch mittags
Eartha Kitt, of course.
You got Eartha Kitt, and not only was she the first person to sing in French that had a major hit, she is the first major American star that didn't come from a German background that dignified the German language, a black woman from South Carolina. Can you imagine?
Yes,
she
and,
did that.
And here's a part of the story that people never talk about. Eartha Kitt's mother was impregnated by a white man on a plantation.
Yes.
And her mother eventually married another man. And the other man said that he would not accept Eartha, the biracial child, that she could not live with them. So Eartha's mother sent her to New York to live with an aunt. And all of her life, she felt, as successful as she was professionally, she carried this feeling of being unwanted and a nobody.
And you hear this in that sort of haunting voice she has now. Now listen to this megastar who has good reason to be in love with the German language and for more reasons than one.
I informed them that I am learning German, working, studying. But one of the things that I said was, Ich heiße Anime Bullock. Aber meine richtige Name is Tina Turner. And then some words that I say often is... Danke vielmals, schönen Abend, ciao.
That's Tina Turner. Now, you know, she is married to a German man living in Switzerland. She gave up her American citizenship, and now she is a Swiss citizen in German-speaking Switzerland. Now, can you guess who this American celebrity is who is among the first to make German her language of love?
Jetzt meine deutsche Familie sind. Und deswegen bin ich nach München gegangen, damit ich sie alle zusammenbringen können, dass wir mal Mahlzeit zusammen haben kann, weil ich in Deutschland bin.
At that time she was going by the name of Donna Gaines,
and then Donna she
Donna Summers, who was married to an Austrian, and that is one time part of Germany, and
they were married up until she died.
Right, and she really became a celebrity in Germany before she was a star in the United States.
Of a new generation. Pulsebeattv.
107.3 FM WVIE.
How would you like for this to be you? Well, it could be. If you have the desire to be an independent radio personality, paying yourself, this is your chance. WVIE 107.3 FM and WHPR 88.1 FM are looking for people with outgoing personalities who can attract sponsors. Launch your career on a radio station with the latest technology in broadcasting. WVIE 107.3 and WHPR 88.1. If you're into talk, R&B, oldies, jazz, gospel, or soca, Radio We Can See is where you need to be.
88.1 FM. WHPR.
Have your own radio show. We have block time available. Call 313-868-6612. Radio We Can See. Broadcasting live in the Virgin Islands and Detroit. Comcast Cable 91, 24 hours a day.
Watching online videos like this one.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes, twice a day. They have the time.
Pulse of a new generation. Pulsebeat.tv.
I'm woman. Hear me roar. In numbers too big to ignore. And I'm not too much to know.
I Am Woman, and the reason I played that was because Vivica A. Fox, she's going to do something that is a first. She is going to be the first African-American female in a movie to play the President of these United States. That's never been done before.
Who is?
This is Vivica Fox. She is doing a movie right now. She's filming it. It's called Crossbreed, and she's going to play the president of this country. It's a science fiction film, and that's never been done before on TV. We've had Alfie Woodard. She's played the president on a TV show that came out about a year ago called State of Affairs. And we've had men, of course, Danny Glover in film, Chris Rock.
Maze Gilliam will be the next president of the United States of America.
Jamie Foxx, Luke Gosson, and of course, Morgan Freeman. But we've never had an African-American female play the president of the United States in a movie.
You are historical. You're going to be the first African-American woman to play the president of these United States in Crossbreed.
Yes.
So let us know just how historical that is and why we've got to support this movie, and you're in production right now.
Well, I'm actually going to be headed to production the end of the month. They have started shooting the film, and I had no idea, to be honest with you, when I got the role to me at first. It was another role. I've been so busy and working. I just finished taping Empire last night in Chicago. So it's like the Midwest for me is really lifting me up. We're going to film Crossbreed in Buffalo. And when I got the call, do you want to play the president? I just thought, wow, how cool. Because we had a female president in Independence Day played by Celia Ward. But I never made the assumption or the connection that I am the first female African American to play the president of the United States in a film. Because Alfred Woodard was the first on TV, she did it. Because I had a couple of people, you're not the first, you're not the first, and everyone had to make it clear. I am the first in a film. And I just think that it's a wonderful time to show that female power is alive and well right now. I'm really hoping in November we will be able to continue the prosperous work of the first African-American president, Barack Obama, and then elect the first female president of the United States with Hillary Clinton.
The history-making Vivica A. Fox, we love you,
yes,
Vivica.
Madam President.
Yes.
Vivica A. Fox is filming as we speak, Crossbreed. And I got to throw this out because when we talk about presidential and who is presidential, Mildred, give the audience, because you know so much, one black female who would be presidential had she put her cap in the race.
I know a lot of people say Michelle Obama, but no, I would not say Michelle Obama, although she's brilliant enough to do it.
Who would be presidential?
I would have to reserve that for
Well, can me. I tell you, whether people like her or not, it would be Condoleezza Rice. Whether you like her or not, her background would make her a viable candidate for the presidency of this country. Condoleezza Rice. And I wouldn't really vote for her, but that's beside the point. She's still presidential.
I've forgotten all about her.
Yeah, she's still presidential. Okay, now.
There's a girl that I once knew who often had a friend or two. She gave them time, love, wit, and rhyme. Sublime.
Guess what breakthrough film is going to be remade into a television series the Netflix way? She's got to have it. That was one of the songs. It's called Nola's Song. And that
I didn't
was
remember
Bill
that
Lee.
From Nola's Song.
Yeah,
okay.
That was Bill Lee, who happens to be Spike Lee's dad that wrote all the music. But Netflix now, which is becoming very popular, this whole way of watching TV,
yeah.
And they are doing some outstanding things. They're turning now Spike Lee's movie into a television series, and they're turning the whole movie. It's going to be called She's Gotta Have It, the TV version.
Nola did something we had never seen before, and we haven't seen it since. Here you had a woman.
Yeah.
Who was dating several men
Each
at the
one.
Same time.
Yeah.
She summoned them to her home for dinner, made them sit down, behave, and get along, and respect the fact that she was dating all three of them at the same time.
Right, and those were her pieces, you know. And I mean pieces that when she put them together, that would be a collective one man that she wanted.
Okay, folks, that came from, how would he know? How would a man know? But for women, let me just tell you now. For women, and I think for women who date more than one man at a time, that was revolutionary.
Yes, it was revolutionary. And it'll be revolutionary coming to TV. It's going to star actor Anthony Ramos from the Broadway show Hamilton. And he's going to be the star of the TV show. My prediction is that it won't be successful. Now, and that's only because I don't think that Spike Lee right now has the minus touch. I think that the things that he's been doing as of late, they've not been successful. But I still wish him luck. Okay.
Oh, you're not loyal at all. You just like what the rappers say. They ain't loyal, right?
Now, here's another recent movie that is going to become a television show with Nia Long.
You're listening to Winchester University's only college radio station.
Dear white people, the minimum requirement of black friends needed to not seem racist has just been raised to 2. Sorry, but your weed man, Tyrone, does not count.
Dear white people, please stop touching my hair. Does this look like a petting zoo to you? This just in, dating a black person to piss off your parents is a form of racism.
The show is racist.
Black people can't be racist. Racism describes a system of disadvantage based on race.
I don't see what the point is in blaming white folks for everything.
I really don't see the issue. Never ran into any lynch mob.
It'd be good to elect someone like you as school president.
Someone else is running.
Together, we can bring black back to Winchester.
Yes! Who does Sam think she is?
This, like, Spike Lee and Oprah had some sort of pissed off baby. I hope you make
it all right. The movie which I saw, Dear White People, which came out, what, about a year or two ago, is now going to be a Netflix television show. And it's going to star Nia Long. It's going to be controversial. It's going to be interesting to see how they're going to turn it into a TV show. It's a very controversial film. I didn't like the film.
Now, I was going to say, that doesn't seem to me that it's going to go to distance.
Yeah, I don't think it will either. I didn't like the movie, but maybe with Nia Long, I do like her. So maybe she'll add some zump to it. And by the way, she's going to do for Lifetime a remake of the movie Beaches. Did you see the movie Beaches with Bette Midler?
Yeah, The Dying Friend.
Yeah, and it's going to be she and Idina Menzel, who at one time was married to Taye Diggs. She's a Jewish girl. At least I think she's Jewish.
She dropped him after he came off filming that movie with black women.
Yeah.
And he came back saying how it was good to be back home and be away from those black women. And the white wife dropped him.
But it's really interesting that in the remake, Nia Long, the black female, is going to play the wealthy girl that befriends the poor girl that becomes a star. So times are changing somewhat. So you got the poor person now being the white girl and the rich girl being the black girl. So times are a-changing, as the saying goes, a little bit. Now, you know, I wanted to say this, too, when we talked about this being German-American celebration. That, did you know, and I just found this out, that King's birth name was not Martin. Did you know that? I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No, his birth was Michael. And that his dad, when he went to Germany, and they were studying religion, and he was very impressed with the teachings of Martin Luther. The dad decided that I'm going to change my name to Martin Luther, and my son Michael also will be Martin Luther. But that was because of what happened when he went to Germany and was so impressed with the whole Reformation.
Dr. King, would you list for us the barriers remaining which you believe must be destroyed before you and your followers will stop these demonstrations and give the South the chance to catch up?
Yes, first, there must be an agreement on the part of the political power structure of the South to guarantee the unhampered right to vote. This must be done with zeal, and it must be done with good faith. And this means removing every obstacle, including the poll tax. Now, there are some states in the hardcore South and other sections of the South that still have the poll tax in state elections, and we feel that this must be removed. Secondly, we confront the problem of brutality from sheriffs and from other police forces, from other law enforcement agents. And we feel that before demonstrations can cease, something must be done to end this kind of unnecessary abuse of police power and what we see as outright police brutality.
Pulse of a New Generation. Pulse Beat. TV.
WHPR TV is now on demand. Catch us when you want, how you want, where you want. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Watch your favorite TV shows on demand. And be sure to download the WHPR app. We're now on demand at your demand. WHPR TV Detroit on demand.com. a Watkins Broadcasting Company.
In the small town of Elmira, New York, a boy was born into an all-American family. The odds of him achieving his dream in the fashion industry? 1 in 23 million. The odds of having a child diagnosed with autism? 1 in 68. I am Tommy Hilfiger, and my family is affected by autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs.
Pulse of a new generation. Pulsebeat.tv.
Mae Jamison always believed in following her dreams. In fact, she followed her dreams right into space.
2, 1. Boost to ignition and liftoff of the space shuttle.
Born October 17, 1956 in Decatur, Alabama, but calling Chicago, Illinois her home. She always wanted to be a scientist. She believed it was her destiny to one day blast off into outer space. In June 1987, Dr. Jamison was selected for NASA's astronaut program. Her love of dance followed her into space. She took a poster of the Alvin Ailey American Dance Company along with her on the flight. With a successful launch of the Space Shuttle Endeavour on September 12, 1992, Dr. Mae C. Jamison became the first black female to travel into orbit.
So what I'm going to end up with is, and I'm going to have to paraphrase this, but it's a Martin Luther King quote. He said something like, right, that the judiciary, the laws or legislation can't control, can't change people's hearts, but it can control the heartless.
Exactly.
It makes a difference. Policy makes a difference. And the last one I'm going to end with is a quote by Will and Ariel Durant. They said, the future never just happened, it was created. And we have an opportunity to create the future. We can't do that by standing back and letting someone else do it. We do it through our roles and how we vote. So thank you all for letting me be here with you, and I know what's going to happen.
Here's the issue. The issue isn't who we vote as an alternative. The issue is the reason why we vote for someone. We vote for someone because they can carry out our vision of the future. Here's where we are right now. We're in a place in this country where we've gone through a very bad recession, where we have brought some things to the forefront, where we have more health care for people. It's a place where we can talk about the economy because we have an economy, right? We're at a place where people are looking for a more hopeful future. And so what we have to do is to continue that. That's the reason why I'm here. I'm someone who believes in evidence, right? Scientists believe in evidence. And where you get evidence is from how people have behaved, what they do. And so when you look around, what has Hillary Clinton done? Since she could, she's been committed to public service. So that, we know that that's part of her. She's intelligent. She's been using that intelligence for doing good in the world, for coming up with different kinds of solutions, and being courageous, right? In the face of people coming up with all types of derogatory, discouraging statements, she's been there. She hasn't left us. And I think that's the reason why we want to be there, because we want a future that continues on, and that's part of it. We want a future that continues on. I always say that if you wait for tomorrow, tomorrow comes. If you don't wait for tomorrow, tomorrow comes. So we have to go out and vote and do the kinds of work that we need to have done. We need to vote.
And every vote does make a difference. And can you say something to the audience, especially to the millennials that feel, my vote does not make a difference? Can you say something that will inspire them to know that they've got to get out and vote?
So people always talk about, you know, what you can do. And again, we get a chance to create the future. And if you choose not to, then you're not a part of it, right? If you say tomorrow comes, it's going to happen whether you get out there or not. So you might as well be a part of it. You have to be a part of it.
And the last question, can I ask you just one last question about being a first? You're a first. And if Hillary Clinton is going to be elected the president of this country, being a first, just something about being a first, being the first woman in outer space, being the first woman to be the president of these United States, just something about being the first.
Again, when I say, I think it's incredible that we have, you know, we're at a place where we have a woman who's been nominated by a major office. The reason to vote for her is not only because she's a woman, but because of all the qualities and skills and experience and intelligence and possibilities that she brings for our future.
So as always, I thank you for watching this edition of Greg Dunmore's Pulsebeattv's Hot Happenings. And there was nothing hotter nor more happening than being at the Music Hall honoring Don Davis.
Don Davis is such an icon in our community. You know, all the things that he did in his lifetime that we're still receiving the benefit from. And so it's so wonderful that KIKO is keeping this going on and really making it.
I know you've got to be so happy and that Don is smiling from heaven above. How are you feeling in this moment?
I feel just overjoyed, humble, happy. Just, I can't explain it. It's just, I'm just so happy that so many people turned out to support a great cause, a great legacy, and we're bringing the banking community together, the entertainment industry together, and I just think it's a phenomenal outpouring of support, and I'm happy and proud that we are doing it.
You know, Detroit has really been through so much, especially in the last 10 years, that it really warms my heart to look around this beautiful city tonight and to see it on a comeback, and especially tonight that KIKO and her family was able to bring a little bit of Hollywood to Detroit with myself, Vivica Fox, and Laz Alonso co-hosting the Bankers Association.
The importance of a Don Davis for you would be what?
Banking. Black banking. You know, right now, it's an election year, and you hear certain candidates talking about how bad the African-American community is doing and how poor they are, and they walk outside and they get shot, and that's just not true. You can't just collectively just throw a blanket on everybody and say all black people are living in hell. That's wrong. So it's an election year. It's very important for us to really know what's going on, see through all the BS, and come together as a unit and understand, as a collective, and understand that our vote was only legitimized 51 years ago. And in the last 51 years, you look at people like a Don Davis and see what he's accomplished, and other black bankers that are here, and just black people in general. We've come a long way in 51 years, and the next 51 years are going to be even better than the last 51 years. You can't stop this. So this is something that I wanted to come support, not only for the importance of the legacy that he has established, you know, for himself, what he's left behind, but also how important this year is for us as a people.
I was called by KIKO Davis, Don Davis' wife, and she's done a tremendous job in leading the foundation and continuing Don Davis's legacy,
yes,
so that his positive efforts continue even after his death.
So it's a pleasure to be here. I love the kids. We support them at all their events, and of course this is a very, very good event tonight for Mr. Davis.
As always, I thank you for watching this edition of Greg Dunmore's Pulsebeattv's Hot Happening.
And when you kiss, you know.